Hey guys, Penguin Recordings here, and as requested, we're going to be benchmarking the latest AAA title to hit the Linux gaming platform, and that is Total War Warhammer. Let's get started. The first thing to notice is the missing AMD Gaming Evolved logo from the Linux version, whereas it is present on the Windows intro. Moving on to the CPU and RAM usage at Ultra, we have a slightly higher CPU usage on the Linux side, but the most notable thing is that the RAM utilization is 2.5 gigs on the Linux side compared to the 1.7 to 1.8 gigs of RAM usage on the Windows side. Once again, Farrell doing its magic with the beauty of the Linux platform, the loading times are much faster on the Linux version. It clocks in over 1 minute and 10 seconds faster than the Windows version, as you can see here. These settings are identical on both platforms with the exception of the DirectX 11 and DirectX 12 toggle. Alright, we come to the juicy part, and that's the side-by-side comparison. We're starting off with DirectX 12 on Windows on the right and OpenGL 4 on Ubuntu. Considering that DirectX 12 is the flagship API of Windows right now compared to OpenGL 4, which is a rather dated API, we're only seeing about a 7 to 10 frames per second difference on average here, and that can likely be attributed to Farrell's indirect X layers overhead. So it would be interesting to see what they have for us next year when they bring in Vulkan. It's likely we can overcome DirectX 12 here. Now moving on to the default side, which is what most people will get on the Windows side when using DirectX 11, we do see a higher performance here, and we're seeing on average about 10 to 15 frames per second difference higher. So we're seeing about 10 to 15 frames per second more on Windows compared to the OpenGL side here, but that is to be expected. Nvidia has a very strong DirectX 11 system of support here, so it's a little bit interesting to see that a past gen API runs better than a current gen API. And to sort of showcase this point, I'm going to showcase Windows side by side here. So we have DirectX 11 against DirectX 12 here, and consistently DirectX 11 is beating DirectX 12. Now this is interesting because in my past videos that I've done before, Vulkan has an increase over DirectX 11, and if DirectX 11 is beating DirectX 12 in this scenario, so long as we move towards Vulkan in the future ports, there's a likelihood that we don't just get performance parity, we may even, hopefully, be able to overcome this performance with future Linux ports from Farrell. That said though, we don't know how much the Farrell and DirectX layers ports will have as an effect with their overhead on the Linux port. So the graphs are pretty much showing what we saw in the side-by-side just now, with the Windows version generally leading overall by anywhere from 7 to 15 frames per second depending on the API. The frame times here do show that there is a slightly higher frame time on the Linux side, with anywhere from a single millisecond higher to about 4 milliseconds higher. I also gave multiple driver versions a go, but there was no real significant difference between them. Alright, summary time! So overall, this is a solid port by Farrell for the performance sector. However, this port isn't exactly perfect. With Farrell's recent RTS ports, each one of these has had an Achilles heel, and that is the multiplayer. We're stuck with it currently being Linux versus Linux, and they hope to, in the future, have it be Linux versus Mac. The problem is that this can't continue to be a trend. If they continue to bring out brand new RTS games, they really need to overcome this problem and make it multi-platform multiplayer. It's an absolute necessity. Now, considering we're still using OpenGL here, a rather outdated API now on the Linux side, and on top of the overhead introduced by Farrell's indirectX layer, it looks like they've done a really good job at keeping the performance gap really close. 7 to 10 frames per second difference on average, most people aren't going to notice unless you're running on lower end hardware. So this does lead me to believe that if Farrell uses Vulkan and they use it correctly, as efficiently as they're using OpenGL right now, next year we may have performance that matches DirectX 12 and may even overcome it if they can match the DirectX 11 performance that's on Windows right now. So why am I making this claim? Well, in the past I've done an Nvidia Dota 2 benchmark video, which I'll link right here if you'd like to check it out. And Vulkan does overall better than DirectX 11 here. And this is by Valve, the guys who really know what they're doing. And this is coming from a game that was initially Windows first, and where the Linux version was naturally at a disadvantage with a translation layer as well. So if Vulkan there was able to overcome DirectX 11, it's definitely going to be able to boost the performance that Feral can get here as well. And as we saw earlier in this video, DirectX 11 overtakes DirectX 12. So naturally, if Vulkan is used correctly, we can overtake DirectX 11, which may also mean we can overtake DirectX 12. It may not be the same for the Red Camp though, because AMD does seem to favor DirectX 12 very heavily right now. Overall, this is a great and solid port by Feral Interactive. It's pretty awesome that we have this so close to its release date in this year. We were only a few months later than the Windows version release. And we have feature parity on the graphics side and graphics options. So that's it for this benchmark video, guys. I hope I covered everything properly. If I've made any mistakes, let me know in the comments down below. And thank you for watching.